Hey, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are still making our robots draw on the board. You see, we have two robots and a lot of cards. Let me take this off for the moment because I'm gonna use this robot here together with this marker. And all the cards that you see already on the table make a program, a long program, I would say, starting from this card over here, and then following the first row, the second one, and the third, which is split into two parts in order not to cover the board. Okay? Our robot starts from here and executes the entire program having a marker in it. Here it is. So, move forward, turn left. Move forward, turn left. Move forward, turn right. Forward, forward, right, second row. Forward, forward, right. Here we are, you see. Forward, forward, right, forward, left, forward, forward, left, forward, forward. Okay, let me take the robot off to see what happened. As you can see, the robot having a marker in it and taking the marker down while moving left this track that made a drawing. What does the drawing represent? I don't know. It is up to you to try to interpret it. I intended to draw a tree. Does it seem a tree? I don't know. Maybe a little bit. Let me just use these gray tiles to mark in a more evident way the boxes where the robot left its track. Okay, here we are. Okay, I don't know if right now the tree is more recognizable than before, but in any way, this is the drawing that I wanted to make, and I'm pretty happy that the program worked fine to draw exactly what I had in mind. This is not necessarily true, because as you know, when there is a long program like this that has been written before testing it, when we tested the first time, we could discover errors called also bugs. And computer programmers spend a lot of time in debugging, which means finding and fixing their own programming errors. So in this case, when we tested the program, we find it correct. So we don't need to modify it in order to fix bugs, errors, okay? But right now, I want to tell you something about this way of making drawings. Because there are robots called plotters that make drawings exactly like this. So plotters are robots that move a pen or a marker on a sheet of paper in order to make drawings. And in order to make the drawings that we want, we need to provide instructions to them. And the instructions make them move in such a way that the drawing then appears. Plotters are also able to change colors, have different markers, and they can choose which marker to use at any step in order to possibly make colorful drawings. Much more recognizable and nicer than mine. Okay, but plotters are not the only robots able to make drawings. So right now I want to keep all these cards away because I want to show you another way of making the same drawing by using our second robot. This is not a plotter, but this works in a different way. This is a robot that starts always from here, the top left corner of our board, and follows the first row box by box. And when it reaches the last box of the first row, instead of going here, which means outside the board, or moving down and going around, it restarts from the first box in the second row. And then it keeps following the second row up to the end of the row, and at the end of the row it goes directly to the first box of the third row, and so on. This doesn't mean that it can fly, for instance, but this means that it knows exactly how to reach this box. For instance, this can be done in this way, by turning right, forward, right, forward, 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 right, right. But it moves so fast along this path that from ear to ear it is like a jump for our purposes. Okay, so let's assume that we have such a robot that goes in this way, pop 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 pop, covering or visiting all the boxes in our board, always in the same order. We do something very similar with our eyes. Do you know when? When we read. When we read, we usually start from a fixed position. In Italian, for instance, and in English, we usually start from the up left corner of the page. And then we follow a row. Once we reach the end of the row, we start from the beginning of the second row, and so on. And our eyes jump very quickly to the beginning of the second row when we have reached the end of the first one. Okay, so assume that our robot goes exactly the same way. And now let me keep off all these tiles, because this time I don't need to tell my robot how to move around the board, because I know that the robot knows exactly how to move. And I also know that the robot follows always the same path, visiting all the boxes in the order that I said. Okay? Now, what I could do to let the robot make the drawing, instead of deciding which path to make it follow, I can tell it what to do in each box. So, for instance, when the robot is on this box, I can tell it skip. What does skip mean? It means that the robot does not leave a track on this box. While on this one, I'll tell the robot, for instance, color. And color for the robot, for my robot here, which is a fairly simple robot, means just leave this tile. And then on this box, I tell the robot color again and color again, while at this point I'll tell him skip, skip color, and here is skip color, skip, skip color, 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 skip, skip, skip color, skip, skip color, 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 and color. And there is the same drawing but made in a completely different way. Instead of giving the robot instructions to move, we told the robot just what to do on each box that the robot visited. Okay? There are robots working exactly in this way, and these kind of robots are called printers. So in practice we have two types of robots, plotters and printers. And we use both of them to make drawings and to print something which is, for instance, on our computers. When we want to print something which we receive on our smartphone, on our computer, we use either a plotter or a printer, either this kind of robot or this one. Okay, but now let me try to provide this RobyPrinter the instructions to make this drawing much faster than in our first example. To do so, I need a rhythm, like for instance this one. And I assume that each tap on the table corresponds of a move of our robot. So at the first tap, I assume the robot is here, and the second tap, I assume it is here. So I know exactly how fast it moves, and I need to provide instructions at the same pace, okay? So let's try for making this drawing here. So skip, color, 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 skip, skip, color, skip, color, skip, skip, color, 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 skip, 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 color, skip, skip, color, 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 color. Okay? I could even say nothing instead of skip, and it would be something like this. Color, 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 color. Okay. Now I'd like to draw something else using my printer, and I invite you to try to make the drawing that I have in mind following the instructions that I'm gonna provide to our RobyPrinter. Are you ready? So what I mean is that I will say again something like draw or color and so on. And assuming that we start from here and we go rows by rows, row by row, you have to keep the boxes empty if I say nothing, and to color them if I say color, okay? But I won't move the robot. I will just assume that we know how the robot will move. Okay, are you ready? Let me see. Let's see if I am able to provide the right instructions. I hope so. Let me try. color. Ah, wrong program. I provided the wrong instructions because I know that what I said does not correspond to what I wanted to make you draw. Let me try again. Color. This time I hope that my instructions were correct to make you draw what I had in mind. Let's try. I hope that you succeed in drawing something which makes sense. Enjoy. Bye bye.